Welcome to part two of our video series on mixtures. In our last video, we talked about the different types of mixtures: homogeneous mixtures, mixtures that look the same throughout, and heterogeneous mixtures, mixtures that don't look the same throughout. This video is going to focus on the homogeneous mixtures. Homogeneous mixtures are mixtures that look the same throughout, and they can be classified as solutions, suspensions, or colloidal dispersions. We'll talk about all three coming up. The one you're probably most familiar with are solutions. Solutions are a mixture where one substance gets dissolved into another substance. And good examples of these are Kool-Aid or salt water. Air is also a mixture, as would be gold jewelry like metal alloys that you might have at home. It's important to note that all solutions are homogeneous mixtures because they look the same. Most mixtures are also clear. You can see through them. Once you stir the Kool-Aid mix into the glass of water, you can see through it. Even though it's, you know, tinted red or blue or whatever color the Kool-Aid might be, you can still see through it. It's clear. And you can no longer see the Kool-Aid mix because it's dissolved. So it looks the same throughout. So it's homogeneous. I like to tell people homogeneous mixtures, all solutions are homogeneous mixtures, but not all homogeneous mixtures are solutions. All right. I hope that makes sense. So keep that in mind. Solutions, one substance gets dissolved into another. The next type of homogeneous mixture is a suspension. A suspension is where the material or the substance is mixed into the other substance, but not dissolved. In other words, it can settle out over time. A great example is a mud puddle. If you stir up a puddle, you get that nice homogeneous mixture of that muddy water, but in an hour or so, that is going to settle back down and the water is going to be clear again. That's a suspension. You've suspended the mud puddle stuff while you're stirring it, but once you stop stirring it, it can fall out of the mixture. In other words, come out of suspension and the water will be clear again. So some homogeneous mixtures can be suspensions. It's also important to note here that a lot of suspensions aren't homogeneous mixtures. They're heterogeneous mixtures. Salad dressing, like Italian salad dressing, where you've got the herbs and spices and stuff that settle out to the bottom, you have to shake them up before you put it on your salad. That's a heterogeneous mixture because you can tell the difference between the liquid salad dressing and the herbs and spices. You can see the difference. So it's heterogeneous, not homogeneous. But a mud puddle looks the same throughout when you stir it up. So that would be homogeneous. So not all suspensions are homogeneous mixtures. The last one we have here are colloidal dispersions. Colloidal dispersions are interesting because they're mixtures where the substances are mixed but not dissolved, kind of like a suspension, but these will not settle out over time. The particles are so small that they will stay suspended indefinitely. Milk is an example of a colloidal dispersion, as is fog or whipped cream or mayonnaise. You cannot see through a colloidal dispersion. They look solid or opaque. Fog is a good example. The thicker the fog gets, the harder it is to see through it. And that's a good example of a colloidal dispersion. So we have those different types of homogeneous mixtures: solutions, suspensions, and colloidal dispersions. Lastly, it's always important to remember you can separate a mixture using physical properties like density or color or, you know, melting point or something like that. That's very different from compounds that you have to take through a chemical reaction. A good example, there is no filter or magnet or anything like that that will separate water into hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. That has to be done with a chemical reaction. On the flip side, mixtures can be separated with filters or magnets or things like that. So you have to remember There's a big difference when it comes to separating mixtures and compounds, and it's one that students often mix up. So really be careful with that concept. More to come in part 3 of mixtures.